Good day, everyone. This is Dean Calhoun, and welcome to this episode of Whiteboard Friday. In today's episode, we're going to discuss ADEs and their application to cleaning validation. For the purpose of today's discussion, we're going to assume that ADEs and PDEs are the same thing. If you go in the actual regulation and kind of look at things, some of the definitions are a little bit different, but that's not important for today's discussion. So the first thing I want to do is define what is an ADE. The ADE is the daily dose which below no adverse events are anticipated by any route, even if the exposure occurs for over a lifetime. So let's talk about what is an ADE. So an ADE is divided is the point of departure times the body weight divided by the composite uncertainty factor times a modifying factor times a PK factor. And so, you know, here's what all the acronyms mean, so you can look those up. And I should mention that your ADEs really should be calculated by a qualified toxicologist. So your ADEs then get plugged into your maximum amount of safe carryover equation in micrograms per centimeter squared. So that's your ADE times your batch size divided by the maximum daily dose. A couple of references I'd like to point you to are ISPE's Risk-MaPP and the EMA's Guideline for Health-Based Limits in Shared Facilities. That's not the complete title, but for the purpose of this presentation, that's what I put. I should also mention that that is a draft guidance document. So once you come up with your ADE number, you put that number into your MSC equation and calculate your maximum amount of safe carryover. Now, let's talk about several different scenarios that could occur. Let's first look at scenario A for a low potency product. There could be several cases. In the first case, your result from your sampling could be that your result is above your maximum safe carryover and above the visual limit, which in all cases is a bad thing. So you would have to do some further cleaning to make sure that you bring that in line. We're in all of these scenarios, we're also assuming that your analytical method, your limited detection of your analytical method, is robust enough where it's below the visual limit. The next scenario is where you're below your maximum safe carryover, but you're above the visual. So this means while it is safe, you can still see contamination. And this is a point of where people often get confused in cleaning validation. Regardless of what your MSC comes up to be, if you see contamination, you have to clean it, no matter what this MSC number comes up to be. Then our final scenario for scenario A is that where your result, your cleaning result, is below your MSC as well as below the visual, and it's above the limit of detection. So this is a good scenario. This is where you want to be. Now, I suppose there could be a fourth scenario where you're below your limit of detection, but that would mean you're still okay. Now let's go to a high potency compound. This is scenario B. In this scenario, you can see that your visual limit or your visual acuity, I don't like calling it a limit, your visual acuity abilities, which are typically 1 to 4 micrograms per 100 centimeters square. In this case, your result is above visual, meaning you can see it, but you're also above your MSC. Bad scenario, you got to clean better. The next scenario is you're below the visual, but above the MSC again, and so you still have to clean. You have to bring it below the MSC. And then your final scenario here, you're below the visual and you're below the MSC. So there you're in good shape and you would have a successful cleaning validation operation. So there you have it. That's this week's episode. If you have any questions, you can tweet me at Affygility. You can also visit our website at affygility.com. We'll be glad to help you out. We have qualified toxicologists that can calculate ADEs, so we'd be more than happy to help you out there. We hope you enjoyed today's video. video podcast, and look forward to seeing you next week. Thanks a lot and have a great weekend.